I request Mr. Vikas Singh, President, Supreme Court Bar Association, and Mr. Sukumar Patjoshi, Vice President, Supreme Court Bar Association, to kindly escort Honorable Mr. Justice Dipak Misra, Honorable the Chief Justice of India, Honorable Ms. Justice Indu Malhotra, Honorable Ms. Justice Indira Banerjee, Honorable Mr. Justice Vineet Saran, Honorable Mr. Justice K.M. Joseph to the dais. I request Mr. Shakil Ahmed, Member Executive of Supreme Court Bar Association, to kindly present a bouquet to our Honorable the Chief Justice of India. I also request Mr. Santosh Paul to kindly deliver, to present a bouquet to Honorable the Chief Justice of India. I request Ms. Sadhana Sandhu, Member Executive of Supreme Court Bar Association, to kindly present a bouquet to Honorable Ms. Justice Indu Malhotra. I also request Mr. R.K. Kapoor to present a bouquet to Honorable Ms. Justice Indu Malhotra. I request Mr. Piyush Kanti Roy, Joint Secretary, Supreme Court Bar Association, to present a bouquet to Honorable Ms. Justice Indira Banerjee. I also request Ms. Savita Devi, Member Executive, to present a bouquet to Honorable Ms. Justice Indira Banerjee. Now I request Mr. Minesh Dubey, our Treasurer, Supreme Court Bar Association, to present a bouquet to Honorable Mr. Justice Vineet Saran. I request Mr. Triparari Rai, Advocate, Senior Member of our Bar, to present a bouquet to Honorable Mr. Justice Vineet Saran.
Please.
I request Mr. Rajiv Kumar, Member Executive, Supreme Court Bar Association, to present a bouquet to Honorable Mr. Justice K.M. Joseph. Also to Mr. P.B. Suresh, Senior Member of our Bar, to present a bouquet of flowers to Honorable Mr. Justice K.M. Joseph. I request Mr. Sukumar Patjoshi ji, Vice President of Supreme Court Bar Association, to deliver his welcome address.
Honorable the Chief Justice of India, Justice Dipak Misra, Honorable Judges of this Court, Honorable newly appointed judges to the Supreme Court, Doyen of the Bar, Mr. K.K. Venugopal, Attorney General for India, Maninder Singh, Shivaji Yadav, and my friends at the Bar. I welcome everyone very warmly in a very humid day. And this welcome is to welcome our strength to Supreme Court. In fact, the Supreme Court has gained by strength, literally also, by the newly appointed judges. Sir, I welcome all of you. Your ladyship, Justice Indu Malhotra, you have been part of us and now you are there. It's a proud moment for us to have you amongst us, and we felicitate you. We congratulate you so much for being there from us. Lady Chief Justice Indira Banerjee, It was a pleasure appearing before you in various courts, Delhi High Court particularly. And it's your professional and academic background as well as your ethical qualities that probably will lend a great strength in justice delivery system here in practice in Supreme Court. Justice Vineet Saran, sir, you come from my High Court, so I welcome you here. Justice Joseph, somehow I am related to all the courts. I am a permanent member of your Nainital High Court, so that's how I am slightly connected to that. Sir, I am sure with your joining this, with your academic and professional backgrounds most suitable to be appointed to this court, you will contribute in a great way in imparting justice and also improving the quality of justice dispensation system. I beseech all of you, sir, to use your creativity, innovativeness, and find some magic so that we reduce a lot of pendency and we progress by leaps and bounds. Sir, I wish you all the best. Congratulations to all of you joining here. We assure on behalf of the bar all cooperations to all of you, sir. Thank you.
Now I request our President, Mr. Vikas Singh, President of Supreme Court Bar Association, to deliver his presidential address.
My Lord the Chief Justice of India, Honorable Judges of this Court, Justice Indu Malhotra, Justice Vineet Saran, Justice K.M. Joseph, and Justice Indira Banerjee, the learned Attorney General for India, other senior advocates present here today, and my members of my executive committee, Mr. Shivaji Yadav, the president of the SCORA, and friends. It is indeed a very emotional moment for us that we have one more member of our bar joining the bench in the Supreme Court. It is historic because she is the fourth person from our bar to become a judge of the Supreme Court presently existing, apart from the others that we've had in the past, who have also done great cause in the service of justice. Madam Indu Malhotra ji is a local person. She was an AOR here. She topped the AOR exam. She was the second lady advocate to be designated by as a senior by this court. And in her appointment and in the appointment of Justice Indira Banerjee and also in the existing appointment of Justice Bhanumati, it is indeed a great sense of pride that more and more women are coming to the highest office, and it's a huge sense of encouragement to the lady members of the bar that if you work hard, if you continue to be diligent in your work, you can easily aspire to come to this highest office and take the highest position that one can dream of in this position. I would be the happiest person if very soon we have a judge, a lady judge, who goes on to become the Chief Justice of India, and having in that manner having the first lady Chief Justice of India. I welcome Justice Vineet Saran. He is from a local court. He's from nearby court from Allahabad, a very popular figure in Allahabad. I have known him personally also, and it's indeed again a very heartening moment for me to welcome him in this court here today. I also welcome Justice Joseph, who also is one of the finest judges we have in the country, and I am sure with these four judges, Honorable Justice Indu Malhotra, Honorable Justice Indira Banerjee, Justice Vineet Saran and Justice Joseph, we will have some very good moments in the future. We will of course be looking forward to their judgments and their association with the bar. I, on behalf of the association, would want to promise them our full support and full cooperation so that they never feel that they are in an alien land, and they feel that they, while discharging their functions as a judge of the Supreme Court, do not face any difficulty in the discharge of their duties. And I would also like to inform our members, there are a large number of members here today. Of course, it is a little unrelated to this function, but there is a life insurance group scheme which I just want to announce this here today. It's a moment for us. By today evening, we'll be starting a group insurance scheme for our members, which I hope will be beneficial to a large number of our members who face distress in sudden bereavement. And with this, I would once again welcome the judges who have joined here. Thank you.
I request Honorable Mr. Justice K.M. Joseph to deliver his address.
Honorable Chief Justice, esteemed brothers and sister judges, Attorney General, senior advocates, and my dear friends. At 60 plus, I had become a baby again, being the 25th judge. And but for Mr. Vikrant Yadav telling me that I'll have to speak first, I thought that I'll have to speak last. But thankfully, he mentioned it to me. First of all, let me express my deep gratitude to the office bearers of the Supreme Court Bar Association and all its members for extending this felicitation and giving an opportunity to speak. Thank them from the bottom of my heart. I'm far too conscious of my own limitations. To be elevated to the highest court is indeed a great honor, and it'll be presumptuous on my part even to venture to make any promise. All that I can do is, I hope and pray that I'll be true to the oath which I have taken, which will go a long way, in fact, in dispensing justice, as I think that is a primary role of the judge, to remain true to the oath. I do have some faint memories of this court, where I did have a little bit of, spent a little bit of time earlier on. And I thank again all of you for the opportunity given. Thank you.
Thank you, my lord. Now I request Honorable Mr. Justice Vineet Saran to deliver his address.
Honorable the Chief Justice of India, Mr. Justice Dipak Misra, my sister and brother judges, dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, members of the legal fraternity, ladies and gentlemen. It's an honor for me to be felicitated today by the members of the Bar Association over here. And as my brother said, Brother Joseph said, there are no promises to be made, but I'm sure I'll do my best not to disappoint all of you as lawyers. I've been a lawyer for more than 2 decades, and I know the role of lawyers is very important. People say lawyers and judges are two sides of the same coin, or two wheels of the chariot. I would just like to compare the role of lawyers and judges, not only to two wheels of the chariot, but the chariot of Arjun, of which Sarathi was Lord Krishna. The lawyers play the role of Lord Krishna and show the way the cases are to be taken, a decision is to be made. And it is the judge's role is of Lord, of Arjun, who fires the judgment or writes judgments. So the role of lawyers is very important and more important than that of the judges. That's what I would like to say. And I am sure the cooperation which we'll get from the bar will definitely dispense justice and do the best that we can do. And I once again thank the members, the president, office bearers and members of the Bar Association for giving this opportunity today. Thank you very much.
I now request Honorable Ms. Justice Indira Banerjee to address the audience.
The Honorable Chief Justice of India, Shri Dipak Misra, my brother and sister judges on and off the dais, the Attorney General for India, President, other office bearers and members of the Supreme Court Bar Association, advocates senior and junior, ladies and gentlemen. I am grateful to the Supreme Court Bar Association for extending this welcome to us. We are touched by the warmth of your welcome. On my part, I endorse what has been said by Brother Joseph, and I can only assure you that I will try my level best to live up to the oath of office which I have taken a few days ago. At least the three of us here have been judging for a very long time. For me, it has been about 16 and a half years. Yet, this jump to the Supreme Court makes a very great difference because this is the final court. And after this, the litigants have no other remedy, one. And secondly, what is said by us becomes the law of the land to be followed by all other high courts and other courts in the country. I can only assure you that I will try my level best. In the 16 and a half years of judging, I have noticed and I acknowledge that the best judgments come when there are good arguments from the lawyers, particularly in an adversarial system. So I am really grateful for the assurance of the support and cooperation which has been extended to us. I also assure the Honorable Chief Justice and the senior judges, judges of the Collegium, who have reposed faith and confidence in us, we assure you that we shall try our level best. I thank every one of you. Thank you.
I now request Honorable Ms. Justice Indu Malhotra to kindly address the gathering.
Honorable the Chief Justice of India, Justice Dipak Misra, Honorable Justice Ranjan Gogoi, the other members of the Collegium who are not present here, my brother judges, my sister judge, Mr. K.K. Venugopal, Attorney General of India, Additional Solicitor General Mr. Maninder Singh, senior members of the bar, junior members of the bar, Mr. Vikas Singh, the President of the SCBA, Mr. Sukumar Patta Joshi, Senior Advocate, Vice President, Mr. Vikrant Yadav, Honorary Secretary, Mr. Rahul Kaushik, Joint Secretary, Mr. Meenakshi Kumar Dube, Treasurer, Mr. Piyush Kranti Roy, Joint Treasurer, other office bearers of the Supreme Court Bar Association. My heartiest felicitations to each of you. I'm really touched by the numbers who have come on this sultry afternoon, giving up their lunch hour to felicitate each of us. I'm most thankful to you, and it is actually a very emotional moment for me. I have spent the last 35 years of my life as a member of the Bar Association. I was in the court every single working day in the last 35 years. I don't think I took a single day off for any other reason. I was at my work. And I'm deeply overjoyed by your gesture. I have been an active member of the bar, and this function is actually a matter of homecoming to me. I must also first acknowledge my deep gratitude to the members of the Collegium who have honored me with this unique distinction of being the first woman to have been elevated from the bar to the Supreme Court. I am honored to be a part of the justice dispensation system. It is a great responsibility because this is the last court from where a litigant has no recourse. And I do want to quote Robert Jackson, who says, "We are not final because we are infallible, but we are infallible only because we are final." In fact, it is a moment of great pride that for the first time we have three women judges who are contemporaneously holding office in the Supreme Court of India. My thanks to the judiciary, and I hope to live up to my oath. Thank you.
I request Honorable Mr. Justice Dipak Misra, Honorable the Chief Justice of India, to kindly deliver his presidential address.
Honorable Justice Indu Malhotra, Honorable Justice Indira Banerjee, Honorable Justice Vineet Saran, Honorable Mr. Justice K.M. Joseph, Mr. Vikas Singh, President of the Bar, Mr. Pat Joshi, the Vice President, Mr. Yadav, the Secretary, my brother and sister judges present here, Senior Mr. Venugopal, an Attorney General for India, senior members of the bar, junior members of the bar whom I like to call my friends, the friends from the electronic and print media, ladies and gentlemen. I must say, and I have to say, and I presently say, it's a great occasion that the bar is felicitating the new honorable judges who have assumed the office. And I see the young and old assemble, and when the young and old assemble, it becomes a great moment, a moment that history will put its foot, put the rhythm in it. And I remember the day I was elevated to this court, I was called by the then president that please come to the library, and we well went to the library and had a cup of tea. But today the situation has changed. Today you are celebrating. Let's be happy. I just have three things to tell you quickly. Mr. Vikas Singh said, I hope with the majority of the opinion, that they will support the honorable judges who have been elevated. There are three concepts. Do not treat me as an alien. Second, do cooperate. Third, give me support. Now let's transform these ideas to a lawyer's argument. A lawyer treats the judge as an alien when he only states the facts, doesn't state the law, and leaves it to judge, you decide. You are supposed to be an alien to the case. I tell you the facts, you decide. Cooperation means a lawyer only cites the authorities which are in his or her favor. That's cooperation. Support means when you cite the judgments for and against. So I think Mr. Bikash Singh deserves congratulations that he has used the word support. I treat it that way. Some of the honorable judges said that we can't promise. Are they right? Are they correct? My understanding of the word promise is different. When you say you don't promise, you effectively promise a lot. Please think about this sentence. When you don't promise, you effectively promise a lot. Third, everybody thanked the Bar Association, I also did, that we thankful to you that you have organized this program of felicitation. My interpretation is slightly different. Whenever a judge is felicitated by the Bar Association, a judge must understand two concepts. Through the medium of felicitation, he tries to convey to the judge there's a great expectation from the bar, and honorable judge, this is not only an expectation, but an admixture of both, an amalgamation of both, two concepts. It's almost a Charles Dickens' great expectations, and do not worry, it's a great warning. Expectation and warning are the two pillars of felicitation. That has to be understood. I think in a humid afternoon like this, I've spoken enough for you, and to you, and to me. Thank you.
Now I request Mr. Rahul Kaushik, Joint Secretary, Supreme Court Bar Association, to kindly give vote of thanks.
On behalf of Supreme Court Bar Association, we are extremely thankful to Honorable Mr. Justice Dipak Misra, Chief Justice of India, for presiding the function. We are extremely thankful to all the new Honorable Judges, Honorable Justice Indu Malhotra, Honorable Justice Indrani Banerjee, Honorable Mr. Justice Vineet, Honorable Mr. Justice K.M. Joseph for taking out time and meeting the members of the bar. We are extremely thankful to all the other Honorable Judges for being part of this function. Our sincere thanks to Learned Attorney General for India, Mr. K.K. Venugopal, Mr. Maninder Singh, Learned Additional Solicitor General of India, and all the other senior advocates, Mr. Rajiv Datta, Meenakshi Arora, and all the other members of the bar. I would also like to thank Mr. Shivaji Yadav, President of the Advocate on Record Association. Our sincere thanks to all the members of the press and members of the registry also for their cooperation for making the function a success. Thank you. Kindly join us for tea.